This video is brought to you by Storyblocks Video. Hey guys, it's Jordy here for... This is not a good start. Well guys, believe it or not, but I actually do have 5 amazing tips to master the focus of your camera. Hey folks, Jordy here for CineCam.net and welcome to Creative Tuesday! Now I remember back in my day when I started out with filmmaking, getting my shots into focus was so hard. Way too often I had to use my out of focus shots in the edit because there was no alternative. It was frustrating until I came to a point in my career where I shot hundreds of event videos. That and weddings are the craziest. Everyone runs around like a chicken without a head, and most of the time you only have one take to get your shot. So you'd better have it in focus. Let me know in the comments, guys, what was your hardest project that you've ever worked on? Tip number one, keep your distance. And this is definitely needed whenever you shoot on a gimbal or Steadicam without having a full focus. Now you focus on a certain object, start shooting and keep the same distance while you're doing your movements. And this will keep your subject into focus. Back when I did event videos, I always shot on a gimbal, and I didn't have no full focus, so this was a trick that I would use all the time. This also kind of changes the type of shots that you would take. For example, tracking shots work great. You know, you follow someone from the side at the same distance, and your talent is always in focus. I also love to shoot slow motion, not only because it just looks cool, but also because you don't need your subject to be in focus for so long, since you're stretching out the clip. Turning around someone is also very cool. Again, keep the same distance as you walk around your subject. Tip number two, autofocus. And before you go mad, hear me out. Because there are various ways that you could use autofocus. I would never really advise to rely 100% on autofocus because it could get your background into focus and not your subject. Now, some cameras have smart focus built in, like facial recognition and all, and this definitely helps to trust your focusing system more, but I'm not a huge fan of it. There are only 2 autofocus options that I would recommend. The first one is push to focus. Now you press the focus button, the camera autofocuses on a subject and you film. The camera won't change its focus until you press that button again. So there's no continuous autofocus that could go in every direction. Then the second autofocus option is the spot autofocus. And we actually used that on the Canon 1DX when we shot a commercial for a train museum. There was a problem with the follow focus and we had to continue. So I set the camera to spot focus. Basically, you can choose which area should be in focus and let continuous autofocus do its thing on that point. Now, during the promo video that we shot, I even did several focus pulls this way. I did have to pay attention to my framing and pan with the camera when I wanted the focus pull to happen. But it worked surprisingly well. Do keep in mind that we used a Canon 1DX, which is a beast of a camera. And talking about beasts, I'd like to make a quick shout out to our beast of a sponsor, Storyblocks Video. It's an online library where you can find high quality 4K stock clips. There are a bunch of effects like transitions, overlays, tons of After Effects templates like slideshows, logo reveals, intro credits, and more. And what really makes the library stand out is that there's only a single price per year, which allows you to download unlimited video assets without additional fees. For more information, make sure to click that first link in the description below. And now continuing with tip number 3, which are several life hacks to make focusing more easy. And the first one is a trick that we've already covered on the channel, but I'd like to mention it again. With some simple tape on the focus gear, you can mark your focus points. That way you can get your focus pull from point A to point B perfect. A variation on this is to tape a larger part on your focus ring and use a marker to mark the focus points. Another variation is to use a rubber band and a couple of sticks. You can push them into the location that you want and have now 2 focus points. This even gives you a little hard stop, which might make it easier. Now, one of the problems that we also see is that we constantly forget which way the lens turns. Obviously, this comes down to knowing your lens, but when you have a couple of lenses from various brands, then there might be a few that turn out the other sides. So on these lenses, I also add a little tape and mark it with an arrow so that I can see that quicker. I'm also a very big fan of focus gears, not only to attach a full focus to it, but also to get more grip with your hands. And I would always use the knob of the focus gear to focus with. If you don't have such a focus gear, then simply use a zip tie. That also gives you a similar knob, which is gonna help with focusing. Tip number 4, the basics of optics. And let's start with the most convenient, which is the aperture. If you close it, letting in less light, your depth of field will be bigger, meaning that you have a larger area that is in focus. Opening up your aperture, letting in more light, creates a more shallow depth of field. Then focal length, zooming out, going wide angle increases that focus field. You get more stuff in focus now. On the opposite, when you zoom in, going tilly, you again create a more shallow depth of field. And finally, objects further away from the lens have a bigger focus field than objects closer to the lens. So, if you want to make it yourself easy and really be sure that your subject is in focus, then close that aperture, zoom out or go wide angle, and take a few steps back. This gives you some playroom where you could even now move around and always be sure that your subject sits perfectly in focus. And that brings us to the last tip, which are cover-ups. And the first and the most obvious is to simply shoot out of focus. Something that I also did quite often when shooting events. When you have to be so fast and you got trouble getting an action in focus, then it's better to have a good out-of-focus rather than a slightly out-of-focus shot. So just turn that ring and let bokeh do its thing. And same goes for when you actually have your subject in focus, but all of a sudden he or she walks away. If you're unsure about focus pulling with the subject, simply leave your focus where it is or even pull the focus closer to yourself. You could also use this as a transition or to add a little title in there. And finally is the focus slight. You focus on one object and then you start moving around. You go from one object or subject to another. By moving back and forward, you can get your elements in focus. But in between, you'll be completely out of focus. But that's not a problem. It's part of the style, which could really work well for party videos. Just run around in the crowd and push in to focus from each person to person. It's really simple, and if you miss the focus, it's not even considered bad in such a camera movement. So those are my 5 tips to get better focus, or at least dealing with focus as a filmmaker. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, StoryVlogs Video, for the support, and as always, stay creative.
Hey, Janik, catch!
That was a good one, a good Janik catch. By the way, guys, if you want to have one of these t-shirts, you can find them below the video.